So welcome to our prayers, and we're using two Bible readings from the Old Testament this week that we may hear on Sunday. I'm not sure what the moderators picked, but it's the readings for this coming week that we have. We begin with our call to worship, which has got some words in yellow if you want to join in with. Let we who live with faith in God proclaim, Lord,
Lord,
you
you are
are
my
my
refuge,
refuge and
my
my
fortress,
fortress.
my
My
God, I
God,
will
I will
trust
trust forever.
forever.
Let we who trust in the Lord know that holy love surrounds us.
God's
God's
protection
protection will
will
follow
follow us
us
throughout
throughout
our
our
days.
days. When we call out to the Lord,
We
we
know
know
that
that we are
are
heard. God is with us in every trial and temptation.
Therefore, we will
Therefore, we will
rejoice in the
rejoice in the
salvation
salvation
of the
of the
Almighty.
Almighty. Amen. Our first song is more of a reflective song, sorry. And it reminds us that God is a shelter for us, and it's on eagle's wings.
Beautiful.
And our first prayers. And thank you.
Loving Lord, we are gathered here today to praise you, to sing to your glory, to come together, your people, to strengthen and support one another. to confirm our steadfast love for you and to bring that love to those we meet in our daily lives and those in our community. In the name of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We've got two Bible readings tonight, both from the Old Testament. And at the end of each reading, there's just a little commentary, which has been given to us by Church of Scotland Starters for Sunday. So Hugh and Stanley, after your reading, you've got this little commentary just to give us a little reflection on it.
Because you have made the Lord your refuge, the Most High your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, no scourge come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder. The young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Those who love me I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. When they call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honour them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation. What a promise we have in God, who will defend us, will allow no harm to come to us, and who will send angels to gather us. They will hold us up and not allow our feet to be hurt on the stones. Here we have promise after promise on how God will protect us from wild beasts, from wars. God will protect those who love and claim him Lord.
And as we reflect on the psalm, and after we hear the next reading as well, we've just got a short Taizé song, In the Lord I'll Be Ever Thankful.
Forgiving Lord, we know that we don't always act as you would have us act. We know that we are but weak humans and have faults and prejudices that are against your teachings. You sent your Son to be our Savior, to take our sins on himself. Even though we disappoint you, we will do all that we can to be better disciples and turn your disappointment into joy, and do our best to always follow in your ways. Amen.
And now we have our second reading and a wee reflection after it to Hugh.
Isaiah 53, verses 4 to 10. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice, he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him, the will of the Lord shall prosper. When you read this passage, you can read it as a prophecy on the life and death of Jesus, a prophecy of the coming of the Messiah. This passage brings the reality of God's plans for us. And as this book was written about 850 BC, it serves as a reminder that our ideas of time are not God's.
Let us pray. God of all creation, you created this world and all that grows and dwells in it. You gave us all that we need, but still some want more. You knew us before we were born. You loved us. You are our God. We need your guidance now to know how to put an end to the evil that is encroaching into society. Help us to bring this world back into communion with you. Send your Holy Spirit to enter the hearts of those who have the power to make a difference, to stop the hatred and the greed that is on the rise. Bring us back to a world where peace and love abound, and all live in fellowship with one another. All this we ask in the name of your Son, Jesus, who came to bring light to the world. Amen.
Amen. We've now got our church family prayers. We remember those known to us. Whether their names are spoken or just remembered in silence, and particularly those who are named in our book of prayer, Sunday by Sunday. So let's continue in some prayer. God, our Father, Jesus, your Son, we come before you in these final prayers, asking for healing, health and wholeness for those whom we know and love. We first of all pray for ourselves. We pray for our own strength and well-being, and to know that in our daily lives that you are with us. We thank you for our church family and for our church community. We thank you for the opportunities yesterday to meet twice together as church family of all ages, and then later in the afternoon where we met all ages again together, but remembering all creatures great and small. We pray for those whom we love, those whom we remember. And we name before you, Lord, the family of the late George Dick, whom Margaret is conducting the funeral service this week. We pray for and remember Sadie Nisbet, who's had a bad fall, her husband and family too. We pray for Mary Baird and June, Peggy Spears, Helen Clark, Linda Cooper, Alex Tweedy are in our prayers too. We remember those who are just unwell at the moment and not able to come to church. We remember Kathy Bryden, Mary Mooney, and we remember Sophia Thomas, whom we remember week in and week out. We pray for all our office bearers who help keep things steady. All these things we ask in your glorious name. God of strange reversals and healing mysteries, we thank you for giving us a divine King who has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Enable us when we are confronted by the vulnerability and suffering of others to make those choices that will keep us in tune with your generous love and thereby create small colonies of heaven where you are truly worshipped, adored and glorified. For your name's sake. And it's the words of the Divine King that we conclude these church family prayers, the words that he taught his first disciples, saying together, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We were reminded at the start of our time together that we come together to pray and praise. So we end with praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation.
Oh,
and our blessing tonight. It's slightly different. We're going to speak some words, some promises of God, the words in yellow. So here again, the promises of God. Because you cling to me, I will deliver you. I will protect you because you acknowledge my name. You will call upon me and I will answer you. I will be with you in times of trouble. I will deliver you and glorify you and will show you my salvation. Go from here with peace and confidence, knowing that God goes with you. We say together, Amen.
Amen.